Winter is the season of the imagination, more than any other for me. Landscapes are magically transformed by snow. You know, I come from Wall's End on Tyne, which is very industrial. The snow would make this into a magical, magical place.
The angel Gabriel from heaven came, his wings as drifted snow, his eyes.
So that magic extends into everything about winter. The stories, the spookiness, the ghosts in the chimney, the silence of the snow, all that stuff I wanted to bring to this album, my feeling of mystery and storytelling.
Oh, the snow it melts the soonest when the winds began to sing.
This album happened in an organic way. It was a suggestion to do a Christmas record, and I said, let's do something wider than that. Let's do a winter record.
And when a woman tells me my face she'll soon forget.
There are some folk songs, one particular folk song from my hometown of Newcastle called The Snow It Melts the Soonest. It reminds me of the Northumberland moors in the winter. Starkly, bleakly beautiful.
Oh, the snow it melts the soonest when.
It's a dark time, it's a cold time. It's also a time of warmth and family and love and tenderness. And so all of those things are ingredients in this kind of soup which we've created. I was drawn to songs that had an ambivalent quality about them, because that's the way I feel about the winter and Christmas generally.
Hush, child, let your mommy sleep into the night until we rise.
What I found is that there were a lot of lullabies, and lullabies seem to have a dual purpose. One is to soothe the child, and the other, paradoxically, is the opposite, is to disturb the child. So you have these wonderful, lilting, rocking melodies to put you to sleep, but the lyrics are generally about terror.
Oh, my dear heart, young Jesus, sweet, prepare thy cradle.
I'm very much a winter person, and a lot of my songs are relate to that theme anyway. It's just the, you know, part of the landscape, if you like.
Mercury falling, arise from my bed. I have to hold my head.
I've sort of figured out what my job is over the years, and that my interest is kind of wide. I like classical music, I like pop music, I like jazz, and I like folk music. I try and draw from those traditions and synthesize something new.
I still see her face, as beautiful as day. It's easy to remember, remember my love that way. All I hear is that lonesome, lonesome sound, and the hounds of winter.
Soulcake is a song I've known since I was a kid. I knew it was a begging song, but I didn't really know the derivation of the whole thing. And we did some research and we found out that it's actually pre-Christian.
A soulcake, these good misses of soulcake.
And they would make food for the souls of the dead in the Celtic festival of the dead, what is now known as Halloween. It's a very old festival. And the soulcakes were there to appease the ghosts of the past.
Soulcake, soulcake, these goodness is a soulcake. An apple, a pear, a plum, or a cherry.
That's the derivation, and it's a very interesting one. It kind of ties in with the whole record of treating with the spirits of the past so that you can move forward.
Soulcake, soulcake, these goodness is a
soul. You know, I would say, if I have a spirituality at all, it's about music. I play and I listen to music as if it really matters to my soul, to my eternal being.